12. I will exalt you, Lord, for you lifted me up out of the depths and did not let my enemies gloat over me. Lord, my God, I called to you for your help, and you healed me. You, Lord, brought me up from the realm of the dead. You spared me from going down to the pit. Sing the praises of the Lord, you, his faithful people. Praise his holy name, for his anger lasts only for a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may stay for the night, but rejoicing come in the morning. When I felt secure, I said, I will never be shaken. Lord, when you favored me, you made my royal mountain stand firm. But when you hid your face, I was dismayed. To you, Lord, I called. To the Lord, I cried for mercy. What is gain if I am silent, if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it proclaim your faithfulness? Hear, Lord, and be merciful to me. Lord, be my help. You turn my walking into dancing. You remove my sackcloth and clothe me with joy, that my heart may sing your praises and not be silent. Lord, my God, I will praise you forever. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks.
Amen.
Let us pray. Creator God, we are grateful for your loving kindness, grace, and mercy. You have done so much for us, and it seems we seem ungrateful. We know who you are to us and all you continue to do for us. On this beautiful day, we humbly come before you to praise your holy name, to worship you freely, and reflect on the creation. We marvel in awe at the earth and all it can do to sustain us. You have blessed your people abundantly, and for this we are eternally grateful. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Morning in this new month of July.
Good morning.
2022. Our reading comes from Psalm 148, 1 through 6 in our call to worship. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights.
Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts.
Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars.
Praise him, you highest heavens, and you waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created.
He established them forever and ever.
He fixed their bounds, which cannot be passed. Let us join together in the singing of our hymn of praise, Great is thy faithfulness.
Thank you.
and winter.
Summer and winter and
springtime and
our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. In humility and faith, let us confess our sins to God.
O Lord, we openly admit that you know us thoroughly. Our deepest secrets are open before you. You know our thoughts before they are conceived. We cannot hide from you. Therefore, we ask that you discover to us our sins so that we may humble ourselves again.
anyone who's in Christ is a new creation. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. Know that you are forgiven and be at peace. Amen.
Seated. On this 3rd of July, we welcome all who are with us in person and those who are on the conference call and those who are on Zoom. We appreciate you and we pray that God continue to bless and to keep you. We don't have any burning announcements. So at this time, we will say to you, in the presence of the COVID menace that's still upon us, just wave to our brothers and sisters the act of peace. Peace of Christ be with you. And we thank you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you this day for all that you have done. We thank you for bringing us to this time in our lives. We pray, Father, for forgiveness where we have trespassed against thee. And we pray, Father, for those receiving medical treatment because of things going wrong in their bodies, those recovering from surgery, for those who are grieving for the loss of loved ones. We pray for those in prison, Father. We pray that you will give them peace. We pray for the children, not only our children, but the children of this world, Lord, as they seek to survive in the midst of all the things that are harmful to them. We pray for pastors everywhere. We pray for elders and deacons and ushers. We pray for all those who follow you, Lord. And we pray for those who are still deciding whether or not they're going to have you as their Lord. We pray for our leaders of this country and of this world. We pray, Father, that you will grant them your wisdom as they sit to decide how to lead your people.
Yes.
We pray for our president and his cabinet. We ask that you bestow upon them, oh Father, a measure, heavy measure, an extra measure of your grace and your mercy. And Father, we pray for those who are seeking you today, that they have finally decided that's going to come on in.
Jesus.
And Father God, we give you thanks for the sacrifice of your Son Jesus, who taught us to pray. Yes. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Scripture comes from Psalm 54:6. I will sacrifice a freewill offering to you. I will praise your name, Lord, for it is good.
Something got a hold. went to a meeting one night, and my heart just wasn't right. Oh, something got a hold on me. It was at a revival one Tuesday night. My heart was filled with misery. Something hit me at the top of my head. Oh, I fell down to my knees. Oh, yeah, something got a hold on me. Oh, yeah. Something got a hold on me. Yeah. You know what? My heart just wasn't. Hey, something got a hold on me. Lord, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah. The Holy Ghost. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah. The Holy Ghost. A meeting one night, yeah. My heart just wasn't right. Oh, something got a hold on me. I want to say that one more time. I went at a revival one Tuesday night. My heart was filled with misery. Something hit me at the top of my head. Oh, I fell down to my feet. Oh, something got a hold on me. Oh, yes, it did. I said, something got a hold on me. Oh, Lord, me, yeah. You know what? Hey, and my heart just wasn't right. Oh, something got a hold. I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah. The Holy Ghost. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Holy Ghost. Yeah. The Holy Ghost. Yeah. Oh, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah. The Holy Ghost. Yeah. I went to a meeting one night. And my heart just wasn't right. Oh, something got a hold on me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Thank you, choir, for that. Something
Amen. Got
a hold on me. I remember. If you go to those meetings and you open yourself up, something will grab a hold of you. The sermonic text
today
comes from Luke 10, 1 through 11, 16 through 20. Listen. After this, the Lord appointed 72 others and sent them two by two ahead of him to every town and place where he was about to go. He told them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into the harvest field. Go, I am sending you out like lambs among wolves. Do not take a purse or bag or sandals. And do not greet anyone on the road. When you enter a house, first say peace to this house. If someone who promotes peace is there, your peace will rest on them. If not, it will return to you. Stay there, eating and drinking whatever they give you, for the worker deserves his wages. Do not move around from house to house, but when you enter a town and are welcome, eat what is offered to you, heal the sick who are there and tell them the kingdom of God has come near to you. But when you enter a town and you are not welcome, go into its streets and say, even the dust of your town we wipe from our feet as a warning to you. Yet be sure of this, the kingdom of God has come. Whoever listens to you, listens to me. Whoever rejects you, rejects me. But whoever rejects me, rejects him who sent me. The 72 returned with joy and said, Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name. He replied, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the powers of the enemy. Nothing will harm you. However, do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven. The words of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My Christian friends, those who are listening today, we ask that the power of the Lord will open our eyes, open our minds and our hearts to your word.
Glory.
And that whatever is said, Lord, we ask that you sanctify that, glorify that, fill it with your spirit, Lord, that it may do the work that you want it to do. In the name of your son Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. My friends, today, I ask that you join with me as we talk about going to tell them. When we think of Jesus' followers, we think of the 12 apostles, but there were more. This scripture from Luke 10, 1 through 11 and 16 through 20, speaks of the 70 who Jesus sent out. The mission for them was the same as Jesus' own ministry. Cure the sick and say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. Jesus sends them out ahead of him to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He is on his way to Jerusalem, and you know, my Christian friends, that this Jerusalem is going to be where the Lord is going to perform his best. He's going to complete his mission for us. They are going to travel through villages where he had not been before. And we know that the rumors of what Jesus had been doing have no doubt reached these people. So the 70 will announce Jesus' coming by giving people a preview of Jesus' own work. So we go ahead of him, bringing his message where we go. And Jesus said to them, you're to travel in pairs. So we can say that Jesus' instruction to them is for safety and for mutual encouragement. If you have somebody along with you, you can say that we're in this fight together. The Lord said that the harvest is plentiful. And it is as true today as it was in Jesus' time. Church attendance is down, especially among young people. People come up with their own religious views, not wanting to, willing to simply accept what others believe and have experienced. Jesus is sending us out today. Jesus warned us, as he did the 72, expect resistance and rejection. But I tell you, my Christian friends, the mission that Jesus is on began in the heart of God. God sent his only beloved Son to this world. And God and Jesus sent the Holy Spirit into this world to help us. Jesus sent his disciples and us. Where did he send us? He sent us into the world to tell the world about Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit is our principal guide, is our base from which we operate. Jesus' mission was to save that which was lost. This salvation is good news, and it is directed toward every need that we have. Poverty is the problem of humanity. By nature, my friends, we live our lives separated from God. We live with a great number of problems and misfortunes, urgently needing the good news of the love and the grace and favor of Christ. Those disciples and we are to tell them, if you are in poverty, we come to proclaim the good news to the poor. There is much spiritual and moral poverty in this world. But we want to know, what did Jesus do for the poor? He has compassion on the poor. Oh, my Christian friends, he healed the lepers so they could return to their work. And I can tell you that he condemned the rich who exploited the poor, especially the orphans and the widows. Tell them that Proverbs 22:22 says that if you take advantage of the poor because they are poor, the Lord said, I will plead their cause. Tell them that the promise of God is he will provide for their needs. Tell them that the problem of captivity, that he has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners. Tell them that the prisoners of the devil, Jesus will liberate them, many people who are possessed by the demons. Tell them that today there are many people who are prisoners of the devil and his demons. Tell them that Jesus is on the way, and freedom he will. In our country, there are many who have turned to spiritism, witchcraft, and mind reading and are bound in some way by evil spirits. Tell them that there's only one God. Tell them that the one that they need to come to with their troubles is Jesus Christ. Oh, my Christian friends, the Lord sent them out to tell them what John says. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. Tell these prisoners of sin and vice. And we're not just talking about prostitutes and adulterers and tax collectors who we knew were sinners. But we're talking about many of those today who think that they are free, but they are imprisoned by such things as addiction, hate, violence, hypocrisy, envy, greed, and many other sins. Tell them that they need Jesus. Tell the wealthy that you cannot get in to heaven holding on to your wealth? Are you going to worship God or mammon? You cannot buy your way into heaven. Tell them that wealth prevented that rich young ruler from following Jesus. Tell them that money continues to be a great obstacle for us, hindering many people from faithfully following the Lord. Our mission is not just directed toward the poor, but also toward the rich. We have rich these days that they want to get on a rocket ship and go into space, spend money doing that instead of looking at those who are homeless, sleeping under bridges, those who are lacking a good meal, those who are, do not have the basic needs. Tell them that some are prisoners of tradition and legalism. The religious in Jesus' day were bound by their traditions and laws such as they could not accept the grace of Jesus Christ. Today, many believe that they can secure their salvation by observing religious tradition. Go to church every Sunday. I do this. I do that. My Christian friend, some believe themselves to be free, and they are slaves of these traditions. Tell them that there are many captives in this town, even in our Christian institutions, my friends. They need to be freed. Proclaim freedom in Jesus Christ to them. Tell them that if the Son of Man sets you free, you will be free indeed. Oh, my friends, I'm telling you, we have a tough mission ahead of us, because many will not listen. They will turn a deaf ear. But tell them that the first Christian church cried out to God for miracles and healing, and God answered their prayers. How many of us today cry out for God for healing? And Lord knows we have all kinds of affliction upon us. Heart trouble, bad nerves, our minds are weak. Oh my God, but if we would trust the God that is the same God yesterday, the same God today, the same God forever. Oh, my friends, many of us suffer from oppression, but the Lord said he come to set the oppressed free. Many are oppressed and distressed, weighed down and grieving. Tell them that Jesus is on the way to set them free. Jesus had compassion on the outcasts. Oh, he saw those lepers. And they said to him, Lord, told them to go tell the priests. And as they were running toward the priests, they look at their hands and they were healed. This Jesus is able to do that for us, my friends. Many of us are oppressed by sin and a destructive lifestyle. All they think is what we need to do is just to look pretty, and that's enough. Or that might be enough for the world, but that's not enough for the world to come. Many live by oppressed by pain and hurts of the past, childhood abuse, marital infidelity, and financial injury. Oh, my friends, we are in trouble. But we have a Savior. We have a Savior that's able to take away all of those hurts, all of those pain, all of that suffering. Jesus gives us hope and encouragement. And I know that the Lord comes to the wounded and to the brokenhearted. Yes. Tell them that if they are oppressed by fear and worry, Jesus said to the disciples, do not worry. Because worry will not allow us to live a happy and abundant life. And in John 10:10, Jesus said that that's why he came. He came so that we may have life and have it more abundantly. Jesus wasn't talking about big houses and cars and clothes. Jesus was talking about joy, happiness, peace. Those intangibles that you can't put your hand on, that's what the Lord is making. Many Christians today live oppressed by the evil that come to see us. And we have experienced that over the last few years. Many fear what others will say about them. They worry about the current economic state. See, then we had inflation and now we have recession. We used to be able to buy a loaf of bread for 99 cents. You can't find that now. But the Lord said, do not worry. Do not worry about others' sake. Do not worry about how others treat you. Jesus is on the way. Tell them to live and preach freedom to Jesus Christ. See, my friends, Jesus was completely free, and only he can give true freedom. Only Jesus. The good news, my Christian friends, that now is the year of the Lord in favor. The Lord is ready to do it for us. He's ready to do it for me. He's ready to do it for you. And we believe that the time has come when God is manifesting his favors in a special way. No matter the world is in turmoil, prices are up, inflation, recession, things cost too much, the Lord said, I am still in control. This is my world. And we need to tell the Christian institutions that we all should be speaking the same language in all the churches. We are to take the good news of the grace of Jesus Christ to this world, which is full of needs and problems and misfortune. But like Jesus, my Christian friends, we need the anointment of the Holy Spirit. Otherwise, our ministry will be limited to just what we can do as humans and human efforts, and we will fail. Tell them that Jesus was sent by the Father to proclaim good news to the poor, freedom for the prisoners, and recovery of sight for the blind, and to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And he says, speaking to his Father, as you sent me into this world, so I have sent them out. And the Lord asks that we be blessed and that we be not afraid. Go tell them If they don't listen to you, go out, shake the dust of that village off your shoes. And my Christian friends, from the reading scripture today, you notice that it was 1 through 11, and then it picked up at 16. Verses 12 through 15 were omitted. But let me bring it to your attention. Verse 12 said, "But I say unto you that it shall be more tolerable in a day for Sodom than for that city. If you tell them what thus said the Lord, and they refuse to listen to you, shake the dust off." And he said that it will be more tolerable for Sodom than for that city. "Woe unto them, Jerusalem, woe unto thee, Bethsaida, for if the mighty works had been done in Tyre and Sidon, which have been done in you, they had a great while ago repented, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. But it shall be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at the judgment than for you, if you don't listen to what thus said the Lord. And thou, Capernaum, which art exalted to heaven, shall be thrust down to hell." So when you go tell them what thus said the Lord, don't you worry about whether or not you're successful in what you've said. Don't rejoice in the fact that you have spoken the word. The Lord said you should rejoice that your name will be written in heaven. The Lord said, "Vengeance is mine." The Lord said, "I am Alpha and I am Omega. I am the first and the last. Jesus." Oh, my friend, will have the last word to say. So I say to you, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. My Christian friends, we want to make sure that we always have that invitation to discipleship, that there may be one listening that you have not committed, you have not submitted yourself unto the righteousness of the Lord. Today is your day. The Lord has his arms open wide to welcome you. And all you have to do is just call upon his name and tell him that you're ready. "I'm here, Lord. I'm here. Take me and use me." We thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us. And we know, Lord, that there are steps that we take sometimes that are not good steps. But Father God, you are there for us. You promised never to leave us alone. And we thank you, Lord, and we pray you will continue to bless all of your people. Touch them. You have promised, Lord, that you don't want any to be lost. We thank you, Lord. In the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. My Christian friends, we now will have our hymn of invitation to the celebration of Holy Communion. Invitation to the Lord's table. Friends, this is the joyful feast of the people of God.
They will come from the east and the west and from the north and south and set at the table of the kingdom of God.
This is the Lord's table. Our Savior invites those who trust him to share the feast which he has prepared. According to Luke, when our risen Lord was at table with the disciples, he took the bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to them. And their eyes will open, and they recognize him. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Holy Lord, almighty, everlasting God, you have formed the universe in your wisdom and created all things by your power. And you have set us in families on the earth to live with you in faith. We praise you for good gifts of bread and wine, and for the table you spread in the world as a sign of your love for all in Christ. Great and wonderful are your works, Lord God Almighty. Your ways are just and true. With all the faithful from every time and place, we lift our hearts in joyful praise, for you alone are holy.
Holy, holy, Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Eternal God, we thank you for your son Jesus, who lived with us sharing joy and sorrow. He told your story, healed the sick, and was a friend of sinners. Obeying you, he took up his cross and was murdered by those he loved. We praise you that he is not dead, but is risen to rule the world, and that he is still the friend of sinners. We trust him to overcome every power to hurt or divide us, so that when you bring in your promised kingdom, we will celebrate victory with him.
Remembering the Lord Jesus,
break bread, share one cup, announcing his death for the sin of the world, and telling his resurrection to all of the nations.
Great God, give your Holy Spirit in the breaking of bread, so that we may be drawn together and joined to Christ the Lord, receive new life, and remain his glad and faithful people until we feast with him in glory.
O God, who called us from death to life, We give ourselves to you, and with the church through all ages, we thank you for your saving love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, took bread, and after giving thanks to God, broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you." He said, "Take and eat, and you do it in remembrance of me." The Lord took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and told him that this is his body that's broken for them. Take and eat. In the same manner, he took the cup after supper, and he said to them, "This is the new covenant sealed in my blood. Take and drink it, all of it." And he said that as often as you eat the bread and drink the cup, you show that you remember what the Lord did for us out on Calvary. Let us take our bread, the body of Christ. Let us eat. Let us take the wine, the blood of Christ. Let us drink. Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never thirst." And Jesus says, "I'm the vine. You are the branches cut off from me.
Yes.
You can do nothing."
Yes.
So I say to you, my Christian friends, that the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Let us pray. God, our help, we thank you for this supper shared in the Spirit with your Son, Jesus, who makes us new and strong, who brings us life eternal. We praise you for giving us all good gifts in him and pledge ourselves to serve you, even as in Christ you've served us. Amen. My friends, we are to go in peace and to serve the Lord. But we want to affirm our faith through the Apostle Creed. I believe in God the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived
by the Holy Ghost,
born of a virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. Sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence come the judge of the dead.
I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We will now have our closing.
closing hymn. Christian friends, I charge you that you keep in mind what the Lord said to go tell them what thus said the Lord, who he is, the Son of the living God. And now let us go forth into the world in peace and dedicated to the Lord's service. Let us hold fast to that which is good, render to no person evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, Lord, support the weak. Help the needy and the afflicted, and honor all people. Let us love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of his Spirit. And may God's blessing be upon us and remain with us always. Amen.
Amen.
You're dismissed.
Amen.